Welcome to part two of our video training series on X-Facta purlin design software by Stramit. In this video, I'll demonstrate the installation and registration process and show you how to get the software up and running quickly. Firstly, you'll need the installation CD. You can get the CD free of charge by contacting your local Stramit office. So please visit our website at www.stramit.com.au and click on contact locations to get the contact details of your nearest branch. The software is developed using Microsoft Visual Basic and is designed for Microsoft Windows. The software has been tested extensively on Windows 7, Windows Vista, Windows XP and Windows 2000, as well as both 32 and 64-bit operating systems. Before you begin, you'll need to ensure that you have at least 13 megabytes of free disk space, and you will need to be logged into an account that has administrator privileges. You will also need to ensure that Microsoft.NET framework is installed on your computer. If you don't have .NET installed, the X-Facta installer will automatically install this for you. Or alternatively, you can also run Windows Update and select to install or update the latest version of the .NET framework. Okay, to begin installation of the X-Facta software, just pop the X-Facta CD into your CD or DV drive on your computer, and autoplay should pop up and prompt you if you wish to run the setup program. If your computer has autoplay disabled or it doesn't work, simply open Windows Explorer and browse to your CD drive for setup.exe. To start installation, run setup.exe. After a few seconds, the installation will commence and you should see the welcome screen. Now, I just want to make a note that this demonstration is being recorded on a 64-bit Windows 7 computer, so your screens may look slightly different depending on what version of Windows you're running on. So to continue, click on Next, and on the next screen, you'll be presented with the End User License Agreement. As with all software, it's important that you take a couple of minutes to read this legal document, as the use of the software is conditional on your agreement with the terms and conditions. If you need to refer to the license agreement at any time in the future, you can find a copy of this document in the folder where you installed X-Facta in a subdirectory called Support. So once you've read through the agreement and you're happy, select I agree and click on Next. On the next screen, you'll be asked if you want to create a desktop icon for X-Facta. The default is yes, so if you don't want it, just uncheck the selection box. But for this demonstration, I want a shortcut on my desktop, so I'll leave it checked and click on Next. Next, you can specify where to install the program and whether you want to install it for just yourself or for all users of that computer. I'll let it install to the default location in the program files folder and install for everyone. Then click on Next. And finally, you'll be asked to confirm that you wish to install. Click on Next. And the software will now install, and in a few seconds you'll be asked for your personal details on the customer information form. This information will be used inside the software to indicate the analyst's name and their organisation. So I'll enter a name and my company and then click OK. So the installation is now complete and I can close the installer. Once the software is installed, the next step is to register X-Facta. Registration is free and easy to do. Now, when you start the software up for the first time, you'll be greeted with the registration page. If you wish, you can skip registration for the time being by clicking on either the Register Later button or the Cancel button. However, the software will stop functioning if you haven't registered the software within 14 days of installation. Before completing the registration, please make sure that your computer is connected to the internet, as the software will need to send your registration details electronically. We ask that you register the software so that we can easily notify users of future updates or releases of the software, and you can be assured that your personal details won't be used for any other purpose, and this is all explained in the note on the registration page. So, fill in your details. The top three items are required fields and the next three are optional. Two of the fields are already filled in with the information that you provided on the customer information form. Now, in the required fields area, I'm going to enter my email address And this is the email address that you want the registration key sent to. And we also ask for a mailing or street address. Physical address is important in case your email stops working and we need to contact you. I'll leave the other optional fields blank and click on OK. Next, you should see a dialog indicating that a form is about to be submitted using email. Click OK to continue and your registration will be submitted. However, depending on a number of factors, this may not work correctly. You will definitely have problems if you don't have either a web browser or an email client installed on your computer. Also, it's impossible to test with the many different combinations of email programs, operating systems, antivirus software, web browsers, and security settings. And certain combinations may give strange results. The most common problem we're aware of is that a blank email will appear after you click on the OK button, just like this. And this is due to a security setting in your web browser settings. Now, if this happens, you can manually request a registration key by sending an email to webmaster@stramit.com.au with 4 bits of information. You need to, first of all, request a registration key for X-Facta and include the version number, include your name, your return email address, and your street or mailing address. After submitting the registration, you can now use the software without limitation for up to 14 days from the date you installed it. For the automatic registration process, you should usually receive a return email containing your registration key within 1 hour. If you don't receive your registration key within 24 hours, please follow the process I mentioned earlier of sending your details in an email to webmaster@stramit.com.au and they will forward your registration key. Just a note that manual requests for a registration key sent to Webmaster will usually take 1 to 2 business days. Next time you start X-Facta, you should see a page that indicates you've requested a registration key. If you haven't received the key yet, you can click on either OK or Cancel, and it will take you into the software up to 14 days after you've installed it. Once you have received your registration key, you can copy the key from the email and open up the software and then paste it into the registration key box and click on OK. Now the software is registered and you shouldn't see the registration page again. Please note that every registration key is unique and we ask that you request a registration key for every computer that you install the software on. If you feel uncomfortable with the software registration process or if you don't have an email client installed, remember that you can simply request a registration key by sending an email to webmaster@stramit.com.au and you will need to provide your full name, return email address and physical address in your email along with the software name and version. If you have any problems with the software installation or registration, please send an email to webmaster@stramit.com.au and provide as much detail about your problem as you can. Now that the software is installed and registered, we can move on to using the X-Facta software, and you'll find this in part 3 of our video series. Also, if you missed the first video, feel free to go back and check out part 1 of the series.